Hi everyone. Just to quickly introduce myself, so I'm Maxim, I'm French, so please apologize for my accent. And I am the general manager for Wayfair in Europe, so I'm sure a lot of you don't know yet Wayfair, so I will quickly introduce Wayfair. Wayfair is an online retailer specialized in home goods. It sells furniture, but also lighting, cookware, essentially everything for the home. We are an American company. We did last year about $1.3 billion of sales. We are now on the stock exchange market. And the business model we apply is mostly a drop shipping business model, whereby our suppliers essentially keep the stock for us. The topic I will talk about is essentially how online retail is impacting the furniture industry at multiple levels, and essentially forcing it to change and evolve, especially in terms of supply chain. Sorry. So first, a few figures. Till recently, actually, furniture or sales of furniture online were extremely small. And only in 2013, we estimate that only 5% of furniture sales were done online in Europe. So this means that out of a market of 250 million euro, only about 10 million was sold online. We estimate that in 2020, only, so in about 5 years now, 20% of the furniture will be sold online. So which means that suddenly you have a market of about 50 billion euro, which is opening for people who are willing to sell online. It is also a very fragmented market. If you take the case of Wayfair, so we do $1.3 billion of sales online. And nevertheless, we are a very small player overall, with only about 0.3% of the market. So essentially what it means is that there is a lot of room for a lot of companies to get in. And the difference will obviously be made by who is going to offer the best value for the customer. The question is, why are more and more customers going online to buy furniture? So you saw that we think that it's going to go from 5% to 20%. And a question maybe to engage a bit, I would like to ask you is, who among you, and please raise your hand if you are, would buy a sofa online without testing it or without sitting on the sofa? Okay, so I count about 5 to 10. Who would not buy a sofa online without sitting on it? So the vast majority, so about I think 90-95%, which seem to reflect essentially the size of the online market right now for furniture. But the question is then, why are actually nevertheless more and more people buying online? I think there are three reasons. The first reason is that if you want to buy a sofa or if you want to buy a table or something, when you think about it, you have actually, unless you are in big cities, very limited choice. You have one store, two stores, maybe three stores, but actually there's very little chance that you will find exactly what you want in the store near which you live. Online, suddenly you have a huge choice. So for instance, if you want to buy something which has a great Scandinavian design, you can go on bay.com and you will find it. If you don't know what to buy, Hachika, which does private sales events, actually will inspire you probably to buy something that you might like. If you go on John Lewis, you'll find something probably a little bit more conservative, but you will trust them in what you buy. Argos, probably more on the cheap side, but you will find great deals. Wayfair, it's us, so our concept is more actually to sell everything So you find essentially a huge choice of brands online. The fact is that whatever you want, whatever style or whatever price point, you will find it easily online. If you go to a brick and mortar store, you will be extremely limited by the choice that you have. And that's why a lot of customers are more and more turning to online to buy furniture. The second big reason why actually a lot of customers want to go online to buy furniture is that, I would call it, it's the lazy factor. So, you work hard, you don't have much time in the day. And when do you have time to buy? It's probably in the evening or in the weekend. And so in the evening, you're in your home, you go online, and hopefully you will find something that you like and you'll buy it without having to go and take a car and drive to a shop. But also, if you take the case, we were surprised to see that, for instance, a lot of senior people, 70 years old, 80 years old, we thought they would not use actually they would not go online to buy furniture, but they go actually. Just because for them, they are not super mobile. It's so much easier actually to buy a big furniture item online and get it delivered at their home. So for many reasons, actually the experience online is much better for a number of customers than it is in a brick and mortar store. The third reason is that online or e-commerce is overall much more transparent. You go to a store, you see a table or a sofa, you don't really know actually if you're getting a great bargain or not, because how are you going to compare this price with another store? It's difficult. Online, obviously, you can very easily compare prices, and there is a great level of transparency, which means that for customers, they can definitely get the best bargain quite easily. So, what does it mean in terms of impact for the industry? How does it translate, and how is e-commerce essentially now changing this industry that tended to be quite actually conservative? The first thing is that online or e-commerce in general requires shorter or quicker deliveries. The reason is this chart that actually comes from our own data, which shows that actually, and obviously everyone knows that, but there is an extremely strong correlation between lead time and conversion on site. So here you see conversion, here you see the lead time. And what you can see is that when we ship or when we offer a lead time, which is within 24 hours, we are at a conversion rate which is probably about 2% in average for our product typology. When you go to about 5 days, you are already down to 1%. And when you go to 6 or 9 weeks, you're down to probably 0.2% or something like that. So for us, if we want to have a profitable business, essentially it is key to have very quickly time, and I would say generally speaking 24 to 48 hours of lead time. And that has a big impact for all our partners, because we can only work with partners if they are able to execute on that. The first big consequence is that I think online retailers in general are pushing carriers, and especially the one man or two man carriers, to reduce their lead time and to offer, if not next day deliveries, 48 hours deliveries. We force them also to offer the delivery day of choice for our customers. So it means that on our website, they should be able, or our customers should be able, to find or to choose when they want the product to be delivered. And in turn, this means that actually we used to have a lot of smaller two-man carriers operating in the UK. I think that more and more what we are seeing is a consolidation where a number of carriers actually can't make it work because they are too small or they don't have the technology. but there are a number of winners that are progressively actually taking the market. And among them, I mean, you know, there's Accelero, definitely, that is strong. There is Panther, there is XDP. They have diverse reputation, but they definitely are into this segment where they are able to do quick deliveries and offer day of choice to the customers. The second big impact for the industry is for the importers. So, in the past, there used to be a lot of importers in this industry that used to buy containers, import in the UK, and then they were selling to businesses, selling pallets on a weekly basis or maybe four times a year, and that was it. With online retailers, they've been forced actually to upgrade their operations so that they can ship on a daily basis, integrate with the online retailers so that they can tell how much stock they have, and essentially upgrade also their warehouse operations so that they can pick it back same day and hand it over to a carrier that collects it. Those which have been the most successful, at least for online retailers like us, are the ones that are able to ship same day. The ones that did not adapt, they might still be strong because they have good relationship with brick and mortar retailers, but they probably won't win in the long run. Third is manufacturing. So we actually buy also a lot made to order, so for instance the sofas tend to be made to orders. And what's happening is actually, obviously if you import from Asia, it cannot be competitive because of the conversion thing. With 8 weeks lead time, you just can't sell very well. You can, but it's not amazing. So more and more actually the production or the orders for made to order items are actually made in Europe directly. So in Eastern Europe, for instance in Poland, Romania, but also actually in the UK, where you can see, for instance, a company like sofa.com that assembles sofas in the UK and delivers them within a couple of weeks. And that's a big trend for the industry. And I think I've met, for instance, recently some American manufacturers and Chinese manufacturers, and they all had plans to actually set up manufacturing operations in Europe. One in Spain actually, which was funny for me, but another one in Poland. But I think it's a clear sign that, at least for this industry, more and more the production will move to Europe. Second big impact of online in this industry is about design. So there are two elements in that. One is packaging. So obviously we deliver, we do home deliveries. And before, for most of this industry, they used to deliver on pallets, so it was a B2B type of delivery. Home deliveries are extremely prone to damage, and especially for furniture, damage are a big issue. I mean, to give you an idea, when we started in the UK, we had about 10% of furniture items that got somehow damaged or had some kind of issue. So packaging is key, and more actually the manufacturers in Asia or in Europe are upgrading essentially their packaging to make it suitable for online delivery. The big problem is that this packaging costs more, and if online sales represent only 4% of their business, it's a high cost to the packaging for all their customers, but just for the 4% of online deliveries. But more and more see that actually it's a trend, and you can see that more and more the packaging suitable for online deliveries become the norm. Another thing that is extremely interesting also is that not only do they change the packaging, but they change also the way they design the product. So I met recently an American manufacturer. And what they were doing, I met their designer, is that they were designing products so that they could ship them with small parcel couriers like UPS or Parcel Force. And the guy even tried actually to design a sofa that could be shipped with a small parcel courier. And so the idea is to say, if we want to be competitive online, we have to be able to design products that can is shipped in multiple parcels, but that get fit into the small parcel network, so that actually our prices can be extremely competitive. And I think that's something that we more and more see, especially flat pack furniture, but that is able to ship without any problem on small parcel courier networks. The third big impact, a bit less supply chain oriented, but is on marketing. So, you know, the founder of Vente Privée, he has a saying. He says, customers online, they buy pictures, they don't buy products. And which means that essentially, obviously, the pictures are extremely important. And this is something that in the past, the furniture industry didn't care about. They were just selling their products to brick and mortar retailers, to John Lewis or whoever. And they were taking the pictures if they wanted, or if not, they were just selling them in their shop without the pictures. Now, with online retailers, the only way for them to sell their products is to have great pictures. So therefore, they invest. And photo shooting, which is actually fairly costly, is becoming part of the development process of their products. To sell online also, obviously, they try to take one of the ways they can build their brand awareness opportunistically is just to take advantage of promotional activity online. And for that, you know, they take advantage of companies like Hachika that do private sales. This is for them free advertising online. Hachika would communicate through their mailing to hundreds of thousands or millions of customers. And the only price for them is to offer a discount. So you see more and more essentially brands that take advantage of online retailers just to build their brand. Finally, a big impact, we were just talking about returns before, is the management of returns. So for bulky items, so for smaller items, it's very easy. You have a lot of solutions. You have Collect Plus, you know, all small parcel couriers offer some types of solution. For big items, it's much more difficult. There is no Collect Plus for big items. And on top of that, the customers obviously can't usually bring them to some drop of coins, so it has to be collected. And that in turn forced actually carriers to offer solutions. And a lot of the carriers have invested recently in upgrading their IT to be able to integrate with online retailers so that online retailers can offer return solutions on their website that are perfectly integrated with the carrier so that the customer can require a collection for return on day X and it is automatically processed. There are a few businesses also that that expanded on the back of it. The first one is the clearance business. So you could see different companies. I think about one called Value Tech. And they started, I think, only 2 years ago, and their whole business is just to buy furniture or home goods from online retailers, and they sell them in second-hand retail shops or online. And that's their business. And that's a great service for, obviously, online retailers that don't necessarily want to manage the return items. There are also some companies like Servico that offer to repair items at home. And that's also a kind of new business that that not only because of online retailers, but something that emerged with online return. So to conclude, the question is that I'm always often asked is online retail overall beneficial for the furniture industry? So one answer is no. Why? Because we introduce a lot of transparency online, and so everything is a lot more price competitive. And which means that progressively our belief is that it will bring prices down, therefore margins down. It will bring also a lot more competition between the furniture industry, and therefore we anticipate to see a lot of consolidation essentially of this industry. Because there will be a number of players that won't be able to adapt or survive. But obviously we believe also that it is actually beneficial, and the reason we believe it is beneficial is we think that the market itself will expand. And the reason we believe that is we think that there was not much choice in the past for customers in terms of styles. You know, in terms of, if you think about it, the UK market, the big, you know, what most customers would buy, I would say, in the future traditionally, was oak furniture or pine wood furniture. Because that's what was available on the UK market. There is more, but that's in general what was available. Now, with online retail, you see a lot more styles that suddenly are being introduced. So you have the Scandinavian style, the shabby chic style, you have the glam style, you have the, you know, and I think this makes actually the market suddenly a lot more attractive for a lot of customers. And I think it makes people want suddenly to invest a lot more into decorating their home. If you think about it, you know, people spend a lot of money for their cars, even to buy their home, but they spend very little amount of money for their home to decorate their home or to make it nice, even if they spend maybe half of their time in their home. And so our belief is that by offering a lot more choice of styles, of price points and everything, making the experience a lot more exciting, actually, people will spend a lot of more money to make their home nice, essentially. And so if the market expands, obviously, that's a win for the industry. Thank you very much.